Hello, my friends, and thank you for tuning in. A quick update. It's been 6 to 7 months after I moved into my RV, and I think I can pretty much synopsize what has happened from then till now. First of all, I just want to say there's nothing wrong with living in a house or an apartment or a condo. There's nothing wrong with that. But, and I emphasize on the but, there could be another way. And I think I've found, or I know I found the other way for me right now. And with that being said, it wasn't a free ride. The first couple of weeks was a little bit down, knowing where to park, sleeping inside your RV, not being used to being this type of lifestyle. So it was a little bit tricky, you know. But as the weeks go by, I've noticed that the human body and the human mind is a very adaptable creature. You start realizing that you don't need much more bigger things to make you happy. In fact, the less you have, the more you have. And it's very interesting, because when you look back, you realize that in the old days, most people could afford a house or an apartment with just one job, and they had a lot of time off. But nowadays, I've been finding more and more of my friends and people that I know need a full-time job plus another part-time just to make ends meet. And that's sad, because you start withering away and working, and you just look to enjoy yourself. Maybe one day out of the week, you can have some time off. That's not living, my friends. That ain't living. You know, if you were making great money, you could say, okay, great, I'm sacrificing, I'll be rich after a couple of years. But that's not the case with most people. You're slaving away just to make ends meet, live by check from check, and you don't save. Now, with the RV, that changes. It changes because, first of all, you have more money in your pocket. You can lower your debt, your credit cards. And then after you have that, you can decide to keep working the same way you're working and save more money. Or you can cut back on your hours and have more time off. And that's when you become the retired guy at a young age. And that, my friends, I think it says a lot. It only stands to reason that if you're going to enjoy life when you're younger and work hardly very little hours and enjoy life, that's great. Why wait till you're 60-something when your neurons in your brains are not firing right, and now you got all this money coming in from your retirement check, which still ain't enough because you still got to pay your apartment, and you're not going to be able to enjoy things because you're already too old, you know? And then you check out and the government takes your money. But now you say, well, how can I enjoy my life in an RV? Well, let's talk about that. You know, what does a house give you? An apartment gives you a roof over your head and security. You got the same thing with an RV, security and a roof. You know, you have a kitchen, a bathroom, just like a regular house, a little bit smaller, but it does the same thing. Okay? And another thing that I like to point out, most people in the old days, in fact, a lot of people, one of the main pleasures in life is eating, sleeping, and making love. You can do that anywhere, and you can also do that in an RV. But I like to emphasize this also. Back in the old days, you had big TVs that weighed a ton. You had DVDs, VCRs, DVD players, books, tons of books and magazines. All these things gave you visual and acoustically, in other words, pleasure through your ears and through your visual sensories, through your eyes. But in order to get those type of pleasures, it required you had to have a room to carry all this stuff. Now, with the advent of modern technology, all these things now can be micronized and put inside a little phone that's in the size of the palm of your hand, or a tablet, or a laptop, or even a smart LED skinny TV can now have all those things and internet built in. With that being said, you don't need that big room to carry and house all these heavy, tangible things. So you got 70% of the pleasures that you get through your ears and eyes now in the size of your hands. So all you need to do is just eat and sleep, and you have that inside your RV. You don't need that big house. Well, you say to me, I like to walk inside my apartment, or my house is big. I get pleasure walking from here to there. Oh, really? Well, yeah, I go by my door and I walk by the beach. I walk by the mountain, by the forest. Outside, it's going to be a lot nicer than walking inside my house. It gets boring very soon after a couple of months. I don't care what apartment you have, it gets boring. That's why a lot of people, after a couple of months, they change the decor inside their house. They change the furniture. They change everything because it doesn't give them pleasure. And it's the same thing with the RV. You're not going to be inside the RV to be cooped up inside the RV, you know, because you'll feel the same thing. So the RV is just for you to have more freedom, do more things, save more money, and then your pleasure is outside the RV. You understand what I'm saying? Of course, you're going to have pleasure inside your RV. You can change the color of your walls from time to time. But the main thing to realize is that you have more time to be off, exercise, live life, be outside. You'll never get tired of nature. You'll never get tired of looking at the ocean or exercising or being out there with the elements. But you will get tired looking at four walls. And that, my friend, you can take to the bank. So that's your choice. Be young and retire at a young age, or wait till the end.